Christian Parenting.
Welcome to the Moms in Prayer podcast, a place where we put our finger on the pulse of what's happening in the world today so we can better pray for and equip the next generation. Our focus will always be revival and spiritual awakening in our children, our schools, and our motherhood. We're so glad you're here with us. Let's get started.
Hey friend, I'm your host, Leaning Heist. Welcome to the Moms in Prayer podcast powered by Christian Parenting. This is episode 123. This episode is sponsored by our good friends, Operation Christmas Child. We've been focusing on prayer and parenting in times of change, and this is week 4 of our 7-week series. Can you hear I have a cold? Now, I've noticed that our inclination in the middle of a pandemic or any turbulent and changing time is to turn internal, to become protective of our family and our resources. And while this might be natural, it actually isn't what God would have us do. Today's guest is my friend Gracie O'Loughlin of Operation Christmas Child. If you've been around here for any length of time, you have heard Gracie's voice, and you know we've linked arms with that huge shoebox ministry. Today's episode will explain a little better why we're crazy about them. Yes, they impact children with the gospel, but also because giving changes our families as well. It helps nurture a heart for the world. If you're new here this week, welcome. We're so glad you're here. We'd love to have you subscribe to the Moms in Prayer podcast so you won't miss an episode. They drop every Monday morning, rain or shine, pandemic or no pandemic, to bring you the hope and encouragement you can use in this parenting journey. You can subscribe wherever you listen to podcasts. That's also the place you can leave a review like this one from Mrs. 2003 on the Apple Podcast app. If you're passionate about raising kids who follow Christ, this podcast will both challenge and inspire you. And we shout hallelujah. Or this one by Debbie in New York. Wow, so wonderful to hear Sally's story. I feel like a kindred spirit. I've been a leader in our unique group for 20 plus years. I've learned so much about prayer and my family's lives are changed because of it. At the end of the day, nothing is more important than the souls of our children, the next generation. Thank you for making this ministry what it is. Wowza. Thanks, Debbie and Michelle, for those 5-star reviews. It really isn't hard to leave a review on your podcast app, and it helps others find us. As always, you can find today's show notes on our blog at momsinprayer.org. And speaking of our website, you'll want to hop on our website and go to those show notes so you can register for the Perfectly Imperfect Parenting event. This is a digital parenting event sponsored by our friends at Christian Parenting. You can hear from our Moms in Prayer president, Sally Burke, talking about victorious, hope-stirring prayer. I'll be there talking about walking with your child after character failure. Mark Batterson will be there, Rashawn Copeland, our friend Arlene Pelican, Jonathan Pitts, Aaron and Jamie Ivy, Becky Thompson, and so many more Moms in Prayer friends. I honestly can't wait to watch. And I'm going to pile some of our favorite friends on our couch to talk about parenting and to watch. So you can find all those details and register through our show notes at momsinprayer.org. Now, let's welcome Gracie to the show. Well, Gracie, welcome to the Moms in Prayer podcast.
Thank you, Lee. It is so great to be with you today.
Well, friend, I love getting to see your face across a screen. And normally we're at events together for Moms in Prayer, and that is just not happening this year. So in case our audience doesn't know who you are, would you introduce yourself?
Yes, my name is Gracie O'Loughlin, and I am the Assistant Director of Partnerships and Promotions with Operation Christmas Child.
So Gracie, how long have you been with Operation Christmas Child?
Yes. So it will be coming up on 7 years, which is crazy.
Right.
But I know it goes by so fast, but you know, I am from Boone, North Carolina. So this is where born and raised. And Lee, it's really funny actually, because I was saved my senior year of high school, and I told the Lord when I was born again and started wanting to follow his will for my life, I was like, God, I will do anything for you. I will go to China. I will go to Africa, but I do not want to stay in Boone because there is nothing for me in that little town. And
how's that working out for you?
To say, you know, I've heard since then that you're never supposed to tell God what you won't do. And so anyway, so now I'm super thrilled. You know, this ministry of Samaritan's Purse has been in my backyard my whole life. I actually drove past it every day on my way to high school. Oh, that's that little ministry that I really didn't know anything about because I wasn't in the Christian world in high school. But now on this side of things, I can look back and just watch how God absolutely had a plan for me the whole time.
You know, it's funny. I think I'm celebrating my Moms in Prayer anniversary coming up soon. And it's fun that we've been at our organizations for just almost the same amount of time. Gracie, what is it about Moms in Prayer and Operation Christmas Child that makes us such a good partnership?
Yes. Thank you for asking that question. You know, I think probably the biggest element that makes us a great candidate for partnership is the emphasis we put on prayer. So our president and CEO, Franklin Graham, says the most important item you can ever put into a shoebox is prayer. Prayer for the child receiving the shoebox gift, prayer for their families, prayer for their communities. And of course, we know the emphasis that Moms in Prayer places on prayer for children, schools, communities around the world. I've learned throughout the years of our partnership that we really do just connect on a real heart level when it comes to ministry around the world and the power of prayer.
Well, Gracie, I asked you to be here in the middle of our series, Praying and Parenting in the Middle of Changing Times, because giving in the middle of a pandemic seems counterintuitive. And as a matter of fact, it's just like, why would we give when it feels like our world's turned upside down? This is the time when everybody like wants to reach around them and secure their own belongings. But actually, this can be a really, really powerful time in the life of a family. Tell me why you think that's so.
So I think that for one, Operation Christmas Child, it's all about the Great Commission. It's all about reaching the world, you know, reaching children in the name of Jesus. And the way that we do that is through a simple thing called giving. It is choosing to do something for somebody else. It's choosing to go out of your way to pack a shoebox gift, you know, with school supplies, toys, hygiene items, and it's choosing to focus on other people. And so it is counterintuitive in that, you know, you do feel like you should be protecting yours and what you have, but really the gospel is counterintuitive. And the kingdom of God in so many ways is counterintuitive. So God is a giver. And so when we reflect him and his character and his nature by giving to others and sacrificing ourselves, we get the biggest joy and blessing. So it's like you think you're going to be protecting yourself by not giving when in fact you will experience the greatest joy and the greatest freedom by doing the counterintuitive act of actually giving of yourself. So it's an opportunity. It's an opportunity for parents, grandparents, families to teach generosity in a family. And so it really is one of the more things that's just a blessing in this season.
Well, and it's about trusting in the Lord who provides for us. Like,
that's right.
There's just such an interesting thing in the pandemic where scarcity mindset has just set in on us. Like, there's only so much when we serve a God who says he will provide for us, you know?
Amen. And
like, the most powerful times to do this is when it feels the leanest, you know? And so I really think that this is a really great time for families to make giving a priority. Gracie, you've worked with a lot of families. How do they make this process fun and meaningful? This packing a shoebox.
Yes, yes, that's great. So, you know, I think every family kind of has their own tradition and their own thing that they like to emphasize. If families have, say, a boy and a girl in the family. Then the little boy might say, I want to pack for a little boy around the world. And a little girl might say, I want to pack for a little girl around the world. You know, there was a family here in the States and they prayed over their shoebox that their shoebox would go to a child living in an unreached people group. And they specifically requested that it would go to someone in the Middle East. Well, that box went to a child in an unreached people group in the Middle East. They became pen pals. The little girl that received the shoebox became pen pals with the little girl. And that just taught that family, wow, God is seeing our prayers. He's answering our prayers. And then the relationship it built with this girl in this unreached people group to hear the love of God, to hear about the love of Christ. You know, it's just amazing to see how God turns certain families' hearts. You know, what is it that he is turning their hearts toward? What emphasis about packing shoeboxes is he emphasizing in their lives? So we see a lot of different ways that families get involved, a lot of different ways God nudges them to get involved. But it's just a blessing. It's just a teaching children, teaching kids here in the States. We are so blessed. Kids are so blessed. We are so fortunate to live in this country, to live in this nation. But to teaching them, helping them open their eyes to what the reality is around the world, what so many children have to endure. Yeah, we've just seen all kinds of testimonies, Lee, just about the goodness of God and what God has done in families here domestically through the ministry of Operation Christmas Child.
Gracie, tell me how you would explain this, like maybe to your nephew or niece, that we're packing a shoebox, but it's actually about a lot more than the shoebox.
Yes. So what we like to speak, we like to say every shoebox is a gospel opportunity, because really it is not about meeting a tangible physical need. You know, I mean, a shoebox is great when a child receives it and they receive new toys for the first time ever, you know, soap that makes the entire box smell so good and a stuffed animal. And we're even seeing, you know, in so many cases, orphanages, when our boxes are going to orphanages around the world, that a child might receive a toothbrush and they've been sharing a toothbrush with 30 other children. And now they have their own toothbrush. And what a special thing that is for a child. But even still, that is a tangible thing. And what we say about the shoebox is it's a gospel opportunity. It is a way to share the physical love of Jesus, but really it's an opportunity to talk to children around the world about the greatest gift of all. And of course, we know that's the Lord Jesus Christ. And to be able to say, someone prayed for you when they packed the shoebox. They wanted it to go to you. They wanted to share the love of Jesus Christ. And then we work with partnering churches, our ministry partners around the world, and they are trained and they are the ones who share the gospel with the children of their community. We know that we need to empower local churches around the world to share the gospel with the children in their community and then invite children to come back to hear about that Jesus that they just heard about at that shoebox distribution. So children are coming back to the church where they heard the gospel being preached, and they have the opportunity to go through our 12-lesson follow-up discipleship program called The Greatest Journey, because it's the greatest journey of our life. And that's where they get to learn how to follow Jesus. They learn how to share the gospel with their friends and family, and it becomes about multiplication of the gospel. And it all starts with a little shoebox. I mean, it's so much more than just that shoebox, right? It is a powerful, tangible expression of God's love that begins the journey to know Jesus in many children's lives and then their families. Families oftentimes will come to the Lord too.
I love that so much. It's this way that we can say this child is going to get this box and it's actually just the beginning. But somebody has to give the box, right?
That's right. That's right.
I love that. I cannot wait to say that to my kids too. You know, we've packed Operation Christmas Child boxes for years. As a matter of fact, long before the tracking system was available, so we could ever know where our shoeboxes went. And now it's almost a geography lesson every year. We have to go to the map and go, okay, so Like, we've seen the movie Madagascar, but where's the country Madagascar? Because that's exactly. Where, what do we know about Madagascar? What's the gospel, you know, what's the receptivity like? Like, this becomes an opportunity to teach our families. And we've actually really experienced, like, Christmas joy in a different way while we give. But I bet, Gracie, you have seen families changed here in the United States over and over again. Can you tell us about that?
Well, you know, for one thing, I think just the revelation for children here in the U.S., when they catch the revelation of the level of poverty, the level of hurt around the world, what children their own age have to endure. We have a lot of great videos on our website. And so just watching children, when I do children's church, you know, we of course do Operation Christmas Child at our church. And I love to show the kiddos the videos, some Operation Christmas Child videos, especially if it's about a certain child from around the world, where they can watch their story. And you just watch their eyes get big as saucers as they realize, you know, what the rest of the world looks like. We are so fortunate here, and it's so cute. I've had so many kids start to do, okay, I don't even want a birthday. I want to have a birthday party where everyone has to pack a shoebox, or where everyone brings items for shoebox. Like, I don't need anything else. It just helps children realign their hearts to the heart of generosity. It's a wake-up call. I mean, I'll watch kids have wake-up calls just from watching a simple video of what children have to endure around the world. So it is really, really neat to watch them catch God's heart.
Well, Gracie, I didn't even prep you for this, but I know you well enough to know we're just fine. But it is easy in the middle of a pandemic to feel like America is falling apart. Like, news. And it is scary. It is a weird and changing time. And at the same time, like, I've been to Haiti so many times. I've seen poverty. I've seen corruption in government. We've seen places outside of this. And I come home to my kids and I want to say, okay, first of all, we know the Lord who protects us, you know, the one who's guiding all of this, but we really have a whole bunch of privileges that we take for granted. And I bet you've seen that firsthand too.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, that's our entire culture. You know, I think that's why, you know, we're instructed in the Word of God over and over again to choose what you're thinking on, to choose thankfulness, to reflect back on what God has done, to remember that we wouldn't be anything without Him, without His grace, without His kindness, without Him coming along beside us. And, you know, that is one of the reasons why I think the videos that we have, you know, been able to capture of these impact stories really make a difference. Because it's one thing to say it, you know, as a mom, it's one thing to try to tell your kids, you know, here's the way it is, and try to just tell them. But if they can actually watch it, if they can actually sit down and connect with a kid over a video or experience it that way, I think that really helps, because it enlightens them and they can see, you know, even through a screen, but they can taste it. They can see what it is that's actually happening around the world.
Gracie, I bet there's a moment when you were helping deliver shoeboxes, or you were taking people to watch the process, where you thought, I'm going to remember this moment for the rest of my life.
Oh, yes. So, you want to hear a story?
I definitely want to hear. I mean, we often have you on, or we bring in kids who tell the stories of receiving shoeboxes. But today, I just wanted to talk about what it's like to be a giver. And so you've gotten to be in those moments over and over again. Tell us one of those moments.
So this happened in the Dominican Republic. It was a couple years ago, and we were hosting some of our partners. Once a year, we try to bring in some of our ministry partners and show them what they get to be a part of. So very few of our trips actually have us Americans coming in and being a part of it. Most of it is done through local ministry partners, but we do have a few trips a year where we come in, and bless their hearts, the local churches have to deal with a bunch of us coming in and we're watching and observing what they're doing. And so I was in charge of a team, and my mind was so much on team things. You know, it was hard for me to really enjoy the actual shoebox distribution because I'm trying to steward all the people that I'm with. But I walk into this one school and it was very, very impoverished. I mean, just dirt floors, broken chairs. And the outreach event was happening in a very poor neighborhood. But the school had, it was a Christian school, and they had gone around and invited kids from all around the community come. You know, there's this event. They try not to tell them that there's going to be a shoebox distribution. And so they invited all these kids and, you know, there's going to be a special event. So we had a whole bunch of kids show up, which was great. And so I'm trying to help with logistics. Well, this 7-year-old girl named Hennessy, she comes up to me. We don't speak each other's language, but she grabs my hand, looks straight into my eyes, like, please just come with me. And she just melted my heart. And so I just follow her. I'm like, I don't know where I'm going, but I'm just going to follow you. She makes me sit down. So I sit on this little kitty chair and she comes up behind me and she starts taking out my hair clips and my ponytail holder. And she's just taking my hair down. And I'm like, well, I'm just going to let her do what she's gonna do. You know, we're here for them. So she starts running her fingers through my hair, fixing my hair, you know, and she's just so precious. She's trying to like braid it and she's coming around and saying something to me. And of course, I don't know what she's saying, but I'm just smiling and nodding my head. And it comes to the time where I have to go help with the boxes. And so the gospel presentation happens and children receive Jesus, you know, they're raising their hand, receiving Jesus left and right. And then we get to the shoebox distribution. And I am like, oh my goodness, I have to go back and see what Hennessy got in her box. So I find her and I sit down with her and I'm like, tell me, what did you get in your box? Lee, her box had everything to do with hair. There was a hairbrush. There were barrettes. There were those funny little bows. And her eyes were as big as saucers. And she was so excited. And I just started weeping. It was just like, God, you see everything. You interrupted my busyness to show me the impact that these boxes are actually having. You are identifying the box that needs to get to the child. You know, as we pray over these boxes, one of the reasons why prayer is so important is when we say, may this box go to the right child. You see who needs this box in Jesus' name. And we pray over those boxes. Well, God showed me that He is actively involved in these kids' lives and the giving side of these boxes. We are becoming an answer to children's prayers, to children's hearts' desires all around the world. And there's nothing that beats that. We have physical needs and things like that, but nothing can compare to the joy of what is happening in the spirit when we become an answer to someone else's prayer and we get to represent the goodness of God to others.
Well, I'm all misty-eyed over here because I don't know how many times we've packed shoeboxes. And I, if I'm honest, I haven't wrapped it in prayer. You know, I'm like, here we are in the aisles. Find toothbrushes, you guys. You know the drill. Get colors, you know, that kind of thing. But what an incredible reminder that we can ask the God of the universe to put this in the right kids' hands. Like, this can be a spirit-guided experience, not just for us as adults, but for the kids that we are stewarding here at home. Like, oh man, I'm going to play this story for my daughter. I know she needs to hear that too. But Gracie, you just let this roll off your tongue. But OCC goes to places that are closed to missionaries. Like you said, unreached places. But what we mean are places where missionaries aren't being accepted. They're not stamping missionary on the visas.
Absolutely. You know, the Lord has really blessed Samaritan's Purse, enabling us to have ministry partners in places, or maybe we're partnering with an organization like Seed Company, an affiliate of Wycliffe Bible Translators, to enable us to go into the hardest to reach places of the world with these shoebox gifts. And we have been reaching unreached people groups, which has been an emphasis practice we've always had, but it's something that's happening even more. And our goal is actually to share the gospel with 290 unreached people groups in the next 5 years. So if you, so what's amazing, and I'll just say this really quick, and then I'll talk about Samaritan's Purse and our work, but Wycliffe Bible Translators, their job is to identify, and they work with other ministries too, but they're able to identify all the unreached people groups in the world. And for the first time ever, we know who they are, we know where they are. And Lee, I kind of like to say it like this, you know, Jesus said, he said, the gospel will be preached in every nation as a sign, and then the end shall come. And so the fact that we have already now identified all the unreached people groups that exist is, first of all, that's a huge sign. Sure. And now the job is to reach them with the gospel. And so Operation Christmas Child has been able, in some cases, only able to share the gospel verbally because there is no written language. You know, the Himba tribe in Namibia is a good example. You know, we went to this tribe through one of our ministry partners there because our national volunteers in each country, they're the ones that are best familiar with the culture and community. So we empower them to go to find these unreached people groups, to get to them with shoebox gifts, to get to them with the gospel. And we identify those regions as they have 3% or less professing Christians. In some cases, 0%. We arm them with the gospel. We arm them with shoebox gifts, and they go in. And in some cases, we only have a solar-powered MP3 player. And so you'll watch, we have a video clip of these children, this tribe in Namibia called the Himba tribe, and they're gathered around this solar-powered MP3 player, listening to the gospel for the very first time in their heart language. And now the village chief gave this one tree that was the sacred ground. He gave this tree to be the first church among the Himba tribe. And so now this village that used to go to witch doctors for answers are now coming to this church. They're learning about the living God. They're learning about Jesus. Two more churches have now been established in that community. And it all started with a shoebox gift. And it's just really, really powerful when you watch just how God is so creative. I mean, who would have thought that it would be a simple shoebox gift to knock on the doors in some of these unreached people groups and to be the thing that opens the door to the gospel? So yeah, that's what we get involved in. And you know, there's some places that we can't name. There's actually, we have a whole list of countries that we cannot name where we're partnering and where we're going for security reasons, because it is restricted access to the gospel. But we just have been so blessed that God is doing it. I mean, this is his ministry. He's doing it, and we get to partner with it.
Well, I love that. What special opportunities, Gracie, are there available to families who give with Operation Christmas Child?
So I think one of the neatest ways for families to actually see, you know, some of what they're a part of besides packing shoeboxes is to volunteer at a processing center. We have 8 processing centers across the country, and actually right now is when you can go and register to volunteer at a processing center, and spots are filling up fast, but if a family would like to go and see if there's a processing center near them and they would like to volunteer, just visit our website, samaritanspurse.org/OCC, and you can find a place to volunteer there. You can see where the 8 processing centers are and if there's space for you and your family to come.
Oh, that's so fun. And like I said, you can track your boxes, and that has been an extraordinary experience. I love that for our families. And so let's get real practical, Gracie.
Yes,
let's do that. If families want to pack shoeboxes, and why in the world not, what do we pack?
So great question. Really, there's 2 ways families can pack shoeboxes. So one, there's the traditional way, and it's simply grab a shoebox. You can use any standard sized shoebox. You can go to Hobby Lobby. They sell our OCC branded plastic shoeboxes. You can order a stack of 50 cardboard shoeboxes from our website, or like I said, you can just get any standard size shoebox. And you decide, do you want to pack for a boy or girl? what age group. You can pack either between the ages of 2 or 4, 5 to 9, and 10 to 14. And then you go shopping and you ask the Lord, Lord, show me what to pack in my shoebox. And you trust that God will kind of lead you throughout the whole process. And then the third week of November is National Collection Week. And that third week of November, you just go to our website, and there's a button right on our website home screen that says find a drop-off location near me. And you type in your zip code and it'll bring up a 20-mile radius of all the churches near you where you can drop your shoebox off. And I guarantee, I mean, there's one within 20 miles of everybody. So that's the one way. And then of course you want to, the suggested shipping donation is $9. And so you can pay for that online and do what you were just saying, Lee, follow your box. When you pay for that shipping donation online, then you'll get a little tracker label that you'll print out, put on your box, and you'll get an email telling you where in the world your shoebox went. So that way is super fun. It's more the physical, tangible way to pack shoeboxes. But you know what? In this season of COVID, some people would rather not go shopping. So totally get that. And for those, they can build a shoebox online. We have a very easy, user-friendly way of building a shoebox online. And you actually get to choose the items you want to pack. You just swipe and put those items in your shoebox. And then we will pack those items for you. And then we will send that shoebox off. So it's easy. It's comfortable. You can do it while you're sitting on your couch. And it's just still a great way to make a great impact.
Gracie, why is the timing of this year's Collection Week so important in the pandemic?
Well, you know, I think that holidays are going to be a little weird. Right. A lot of people are going to be having a different kind of Thanksgiving, a different kind of Christmas. And Collection Week is always the third week of November. We've always done it that way. But I think it's especially important this year because I feel like this can be a really great way to set the trajectory of our holiday season. Like, let's go ahead and set the trajectory of a spirit of giving, a spirit of doing for others. And let's just go ahead and set that right up front and trust that that's going to carry over into our Thanksgiving, carry over into our Christmas. So it's actually a good way to have that right up front, right before Thanksgiving. And then, yeah, to set the course for the rest of the holiday season.
Moms in Prayer and Operation Christmas Child have partnered together to develop a prayer note to go right inside of that box. And they can find that on our website at momsinprayer.org. And that is going to be a neat opportunity for them to not just wrap prayer around the box, but actually to slide a prayer in, right?
Absolutely. I love that. And yeah, it's our co-branded website. It's momsinprayer.org/OCC. And yeah, there is a button on that website that says download the prayer card. And what a great way to write out a prayer for the child receiving your shoebox. So you're sitting there, it's a heart connection to that child. And then when the child receives it, you know, they get to have that, whether they can read it or learn to read it. I can't even tell you how many stories I've heard of kids saying the note, the letter that I got in my shoebox is what inspired me to learn English. And, you know, it's just unbelievable, the little things that we don't think about. But yeah, and so it's a great way to just connect with that child. And again, that emphasis back to prayer. It's just all about prayer.
It is just all about prayer. Well, Gracie, we are out of time. And as always, it's wonderful to see you, friend.
You too, Lee. This has been such a blessing and an honor. Thank you for having me.
Gracie, would you mind wrapping up our time together in prayer? Would you just, as we focus on others during the middle of this crazy season, would you pray for our moms that are listening? Thanks, friend.
I would love it. Oh, Father God, you are the God of the universe. You are a great and mighty God, and nothing, absolutely nothing, is too big for you. And so, Father God, we first just want to exalt your name. You are good. You are holy. And we are so blessed that we get to serve such a mighty God. And Father, we just want to esteem the name of Jesus today. And Father, we thank you, Lord, that through his blood, blood that we get to come boldly to the throne of grace and obtain mercy and find grace to help in our time of need. And so, Father, I just want to lift up every single mother listening to this podcast. I thank you, Father, for the call of God on their lives, for the anointing of God on their lives to be the mothers that you have created them to be. And Father, I pray in this season that you would encourage their hearts, that you would grant them to be strengthened by the power of your Holy Spirit, that you would give them your eyes to see, your ears to hear. And Father, I pray in Jesus' name that they would enter into new levels of grace in this season, new levels of realizing and understanding your goodness and your love towards them. Father, we know that when we can really understand your love towards us, it just flows out in every area of our lives. So Father, I pray that they would be rooted and grounded in your love in a new way. Father, we love you. We thank you for what you are doing in our lives through these ministries. Father, we just continue to choose to trust you. We trust you, Father, and we give you all the glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Woo, amen.
There is power in giving. I'm so grateful for the ministry of Operation Christmas Child in this world, and I know and understand a lot better why the ministry of shoeboxes really is important to this world. I hope you came to that realization too. If this is your first time here, thanks so much for joining us. You can learn all about the ministry that God has given us to pray for children in schools around the world on our website at momsinprayer.org. Joining a group and starting a group really is easy and probably the best investment of your time, no matter your stage of life. Moms make the difference. Moms packing prayer into everything from lunches to shoeboxes. Moms just like you. See you next week.